John Orant from the Sports Business Journal is predicting that the CBS game of the week will be a Big Ten game going forward. Now, this will be after the 2022 season, I believe, is when the Big Ten rights are up, and maybe after 2023. But either way.
When is the SEC starting with ABC?
It's supposed to be in 2024.
Yeah.
His prediction is that CBS, because the Big Ten deal ends a year early, you know, and then the SEC deal goes. So what they're suggesting, or not suggest, what they are predicting at Sports Business Journal is that CBS will allow ESPN to buy them out of that last year. So the CBS game of the week will not be the SEC game of the week. It will be a Big Ten game. Now, the issue there is CBS is going to be a dual partner, or again, predicted to be a dual partner with Fox on these. I'm wondering if this is a spite play by CBS to get back, like if they're going to overpay for this to get back at the SEC over the way that things went down with those negotiations, right? Because the SEC told CBS, we will not ever re-sign with you. Like, once this deal is done, it is done, and we will not speak anymore. And the SEC is the biggest brand in college athletics. However, let's not pretend like CBS didn't have something to do with that, because CBS put them on a national window by themselves before anybody else was capable of doing that, right? Before anybody, not capable, before anybody was willing to do that. And they made these SEC programs big-time national brands. I want to know what ends up happening here, and I'm curious your thoughts on this about CBS possibly getting Big Ten games.
Okay, first off, it's a hell of a move for CBS. It's really smart for them. It's also a hell of a move for the Big Ten, and it's really smart for them. That's a great relationship, and that's the only conference that would be worth or justified in that spot. The doing it out of spite, they were the ones that cocked up that whole SEC negotiations. They got the SEC on an absolute steal. On an absolute steal. Mike Slide just bent over and took one. Okay?
Yeah.
Because CBS, yes, SEC grew under the branding of CBS. CBS helped in that, but they're not the only thing that helped in that. Okay.
Agreed. Agreed.
Like that is a part of the puzzle, but unless Iowa and Michigan State and Wisconsin start rolling off national titles, like then we're having a different conversation, and then we can all owe an apology to CBS. But CBS, when they were getting pennies on the dollar value for what the SEC games were. Okay. Well, what they were worth and what they were paid. They were just getting absolute steals, complete robbery. The SEC went to them to ask to renegotiate the terms of the deal. And CBS made it abundantly clear, no, we have a cash cow and we are going to wring this all the way to the bank.
Yeah, we're going to milk it.
When you do that, when you milk that cow for every drop, you can't then play the victim and say, well, they said they would never negotiate with us, so we're going to go somewhere else. Hey, what did the SEC think they were going to do? Like, you're spiting us because you're going to stay in business?
Now,
like, we knew you'd pick up another conference. We knew you'd stay in business. I just wish you kept Gary Daniels, punk ass. That's all.
And they might keep Gary Daniels. I was saying that the Danielson deal has to do with the SEC deal. So once the SEC contract is done, like basically Danielson is done, but they could re-sign him. I mean, you never know. So yeah,
they need to. They need to. He's fantastic, and they need to keep him on there for Big Ten games. I think this is awesome for the Big Ten.
I think so, too.
I really do.
I think so, too.
Now, the Big Ten is going to find themselves in the same thing the SEC is going to find themselves in. 13 teams are going to want to vomit almost every week because CBS is going to pick the big brand, and they're just going to gargle the hog all the way down.
Well, but this
Gary again, Daniels is going to become this, the biggest Ohio State fan. Ohio State's going to get like 9 of the games on CBS every week, and that's just what it's going to be.
Well, this will be, it's not just CBS though. It is CBS and Fox is still going to get a lot of those big games, right? So Fox,
I want to know. Well, you can't say a lot of. There has to be a drafting pool. Are they going to alternate weeks of who gets first choice at top game?
I'm curious about this, right? That's, so that, and this is all just a prediction.
We need to understand that. Like, but we think that's what's going to happen, right? Like, they're, right. they're not going to pick up the Big 12. Like, we're not going to get every week, you know, Texas Tech versus Kansas State. Like, that ain't happening.
Now, Fox will keep that on CBS. Fox will keep some of those. They're going to keep the Big 12. They've got the Pac-12 as well.
But the SEC and the CBS had a partnership deal. Like, what do you mean? Like, CBS only plays one game a week. So anybody who goes with them has to have another deal with somebody else.
Agreed. But what I'm saying is they are not going to get the biggest game every week. Like, they won't get first choice
every
week.
What if they pay the most?
Well, because Fox, apparently Fox has already said, like, they are getting Ohio State, Michigan every year, no matter what. But remember, Fox has rebuilt their entire programming for Saturdays around that big noon kickoff, and they picked the biggest game of the week to toss in that time slot, and they've had a lot of success with it. Just a ton of success. But
they've also been using Big Ten games, Big 12 games, Pac-12 games for that.
Right, right. But the biggest ones, of course, that they've had, of course, has been the Big Ten games. I'm curious how this is going to work with the drafting and whatnot. You know, it'll probably be what weekends these guys, because ESPN, of course, does get some of the Big Ten stuff, but we have seen some of these ABC primetime games have been complete trash, right?
Well, yes.
I mean, no, just awful that, because of the Fox deal.
The ABC situation, what they've done is they made their bed with the ACC, and that was the biggest mistake they've ever made.
Oh, yeah.
Because how many games did we get Clemson versus Florida State, which on paper, 20 years ago, fantastic football game. All right, but in 2021, nobody's watching that. There are Florida State moms that are like, I think I'm going to clean the house. There are dads that are at Home Depot right now thinking, I ain't watching this shit.
Yes, yes, okay? I'm with you. I'm with you.
And that's the ABC game we're getting. So congratulations, Kurt. Like, this is, but I don't understand why they're doing that. Like, they have the rights to bigger games. Those bigger games were played on ESPN's network. But for some reason, they still put those games on the primetime slot.
Yeah. No, you're right. Well, it's because, of course, the brand name. And it's about
every week that it happened.
Yeah, they wanted the brand name in the it's ridiculous. I'm with you. I'm curious. I'm just curious to see how it's going to play out. I want to see what CBS does, what the deal looks like with Fox and them, and how it helps the Big Ten. I'm very curious.
Like I said, CBS has to have a partnership deal with everybody unless they're going to start playing a lot of football games.
And then,
if they're
just going
to do the one game, then it doesn't matter. The conference has to have other partners.
Yes, yes. No, I agree with you on this. I mean, that's undeniable fact. I am curious if this means that CBS will get involved in some of these playoff negotiations. Right? I mean, they're part of the Super Bowl round tree.
If it goes to 12, there's no reason they shouldn't. But they have a history of being really cheap. The NCAA tournament is like an absolute ripoff of a deal for the NCAA, and it's a steal for CBS. If you want to get into the college football game right now, and you're going to try to be cheap, bro, you are going to be hurting. They're going to hurt.
That's what I'm saying. If they are going to be cheap with this Big Ten deal, they won't be getting, you know, Ohio State and Penn State games. Like, they'll be getting, you know, some lower level. Well,
if they get the second choice every week, and you get a Big 12 game or a Pac-12 game that they want to put on the big noon thing, then you're great. You're gold. You're gonna get a really good game.
Yeah, so. I think you're right. I think you're right. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at WinningCures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.